This your girl, Big Doe.
This Mulan, the motherfucking Doe.
And you are now watching
7 questions in a session.
7 questions in a motherfucking session. Did I say it right? You say it.
Me and Sunny knocking hoes like Will Chamberlain. I ain't never shot a jump shot, but my wrist famous. My nigga was a hooper, now he dumping shit, I can't blame. I know some niggas always posting guns, but they can't aim.
Tryna make me switch up on the team, but you couldn't pay. Baby, you would never catch me on the scene, cause I'm high maintenance. Sick of pouring all this damn lean, got me feeling crazy. I just got a box of woods, finna roll a Tracy.
Just bought a blender, now I'm finna mix a brick.
Yo, this your old Caddy Chris, man, and you are now watching 7 questions in the session. Today I got 2 special guests up in here, man. I got Mulan up in here, and y'all already know I got Jay Doe up in here, man. And we gonna get into this interview. First thing first, follow our sponsors, Billionaire Hemp Wraps. Treat your lungs better. Shout out to our other sponsors, Spray 420, best car deodorizer out there. And Eight Off the Bone men's oils and females oils, man. Come get you some so you can get you some. And we going to get into this interview. Appreciate y'all.
Well, first of all, you said it's called Eight Off the Bone.
Eight Off the Bone. Get Eight Off the Bone.
I like that.
Come get you some so you can get you some, man.
Period. I like that.
Yeah, so, man, appreciate y'all for coming through. Go ahead. Let's smell it.
This is going to make me want to eat some off the bone.
For real. All
right, we're
going to
be the
you drink. Rub it on your wrist a little bit.
It smells good. I don't know what it is. It's blue.
Yeah, see, what you do is you just rub it on there. You don't never put it directly on your clothes because it will get you.
This shit going to give me 8 off the bone.
For real.
I got on some Tom Ford and some Baccarat. That's going to get me 8 off the bone.
Yeah.
All right, look, I'll make it 8.
Man, appreciate y'all for coming through, man. I'm glad y'all came and sat down at the table. How y'all doing today?
Good. Thanks for having us.
I appreciate y'all for even coming through, but first thing first, I got to say, I'm salty at Jane Doe, man, because...
You always doing something.
Last time she was in the seat, different studio, of course, but last time she was in the seat, she was supposed to be dropping music. And she ain't dropped no music, man, so I'm kind of salty at her about that. So what's up with that, man?
I don't know. My life really just be hustle, grind. So I really, like, I don't know. I be having shit coming left and right, so it's like, fuck music. Get that money.
Shit, you ain't wrong, man. Man, but I'm gonna start the interview like this. Like, when it comes to, like, dancing in Milwaukee, like, do y'all consider it better here or out of town?
Out of town.
Well, why you would say out of town?
Because from my experience, out of town showed me the most love, and I made the most money out of town. In town, everybody know you. You got more haters here. Out of town, we new faces, so.
I mean, for me, I would say in town. I done made more money in Milwaukee. The city, like, I be having my haters and shit, but the city most definitely showed me a lot of love. But I show love. Like, I go, I support people's shit. I post flyers. I spend money with people from the city. So I think that's why they always show me love and support me, because I support them.
So, question for both of y'all. If y'all don't mind me asking, what was the most y'all ever made in a night?
The most I ever made in a night, it was here. I made $6,500 one night.
$8,500
in Detroit. Oh, shit. That's some good-ass nights right there.
During the pandemic.
During the pandemic? Oh, yeah, you snapped. Let me see where I'm going to go with this. All due respect, do it be irritating when people try to, like, buy sex from y'all? Do that ever happens?
Yeah, but I don't get offended by it because, it's a stereotype. They think all strippers sell, you know, pussy anyway. So I just let them know I ain't on that. Keep it pushing.
For me, it do get irritating because it's just like, even when you tell a nigga what you want, they still be trying to negotiate. Like, how you trying to buy pussy and you ain't even got the pussy funds? Like, how you trying to negotiate my pussy? Like, my price is the price in today's price might not be tomorrow's price. You want me, so give me what I want. If you don't want to give me what I want, then you probably should go get you a blow up doll. Okay.
All my life, spend that cash or don't.
Or fuck your hand or something. That's for free.
Me, I got bills. I ain't a blow about. I got bills. I got shit to take care of. I want what I want.
Yeah, you heard that, man. So don't come cheap. Mm-hmm. Being you was one of the first females here to get their body done. Like years later, do you still like appreciate like you going to do that?
Well, I don't know if I was the first person. I don't regret nothing. I feel like when you get body enhancements, it makes you more money. I don't regret shit. Like, it's, you know, when you in this industry, you gotta look good. You gotta spend money to make money. You just can't, like, these days, these bitches be looking like a sack of pennies, like bullshit. You know what I'm saying? And they expect to make thousands and thousands of dollars. You can't make thousands of dollars and you walk around looking like a rusty ass penny. You can't do that. You have to spend money to make money.
Have you had anything done?
Yeah, I had a BBL twice.
Do you regret it?
I think they want to see.
Y'all let's see.
Y'all
know.
Let's do a spin for
them. Hold on
now.
do you regret getting it?
Mm. No. After my first one, I made more money. It was an investment that worked out in my favor.
Would you recommend it to younger females who want to come up in the industry? Would you recommend it for them to go get it did?
I wouldn't say that's something I'm promoting, but I would recommend it if you got a bad body. If you shaped like a wisdom tooth or an ice cream cone, yeah, I'm going to recommend
it. Or a 2-liter soda.
Yeah, I would recommend it if you're trying to be a dancer because you got to look good, like you said. And a lot of niggas, if you want to make some money, like some real money in a major cities, a lot of these niggas that's throwing thousands ain't finna throw it on no bitch that ain't beat up.
Right, you gotta be done up.
Like, right. some people will tell you that. Like, no, and they gonna talk bad about you. If you got low self-esteem, go get beat up. I ain't going.
Dude, is the rumors, like, real with, like, the, like, dancing locker rooms? Do it really be, like, a lot of beef in them locker rooms?
Hell yeah.
Always.
Everywhere.
Always.
Yes.
Always. It's always beef. Yes. Always.
You know what money, bitches, and egos.
I mean, the strip club, my mama always told me the strip club is the devil's playground, the devil's den. So when it come to money, you know that money turn a bitch evil. Like, money is the root of all evil. Like, when it come to that money, bitches turn, especially bitches that be working for pimps and all that extra shit. Like, oh, them the worst bitches to work with. The worst. Because them bitches, you could be sitting there turning back. They'll drop something in your drink if you sitting with a nigga that got a bag.
Yeah, them the shy stealers.
For real.
Is it like law to be on point in them clubs? Yeah. Like, because you feel like you got everybody trying to take advantage of shit like that?
You should always be on point in the strip club. Always.
You should be on point regardless, but definitely.
Always. Always be on point in the strip club.
Peer pressure?
Go ahead. Go first.
I don't know how to do it. Okay, what I got to do?
Peer pressure?
Just like hitting the hookah.
Wait, no, it's not like hitting the hookah. Okay.
Yes, it is.
They hitting the blunt.
Wait, I need to take the cap. I got to take the cap off of this because I start coughing.
Same questions in the session.
All right, I got a lip gloss on, so I got to go like this.
Go ahead, man. That's some shit, too, so. She hit the blunt. If I get Jane Doe to hit the blunt, we having a good night, man.
All right. 7 questions in a session. I'm about to hit the blunt. Hold on.
She had to get up out of here. Oh, man. I love a job, man.
I think she hit it too hard.
She hit it too hard, man. This that shit, man. Real, for real.
That's that pack. Most definitely is.
All right, I'm going to pause it. I'll go for that. I'm ready to get that.
God damn.
Niggas cheap as hell. From my baby. Oh, on my baby, niggas cheap as hell. 500 yings, I ain't busting shit down. I don't need a scale. On United, fuck the mail. Tell my head, I don't take no motherfucking Zell. Peso in the land. Like big times, we get our motherfucking roll on. Acting like an oppa, get y'all ass flat. Get drove on. My little brother keep that pole on. 300 G's in my closet getting mowed on. I see you riding in that foreign, but you don't own it. Small ass pistol in the club, I can go pro. The paint.
us, they get along. A nigga trippin' with my brother, fuck his bitch, I get him gone. Yeah, I can't lie, but you a timber, can you please watch your tongue? Hey, nigga, ops, I can't spare, I'ma put him in the air, just like a drone. I'm to walk up on your car, like, what you tryna pay? I make that chopper sing, my pocket stay on Roddy Wave. A nigga reachin' for the piece, and you gon' die today. Right, they got no house, so I'm postin' where his mama stay.
On my baby, niggas cheap as hell. 500 yings, I ain't busting shit down. I don't need a scale. On United, fuck the mail. Talk my head, I don't take no motherfucking
shit. To let y'all know to please subscribe, like the channel, man. Tell your people to follow. Tell your girl to follow. Tell your mans to follow, man. Get us some subscribers. Get us some followers. Share an interview. Yeah, right here. You see it, 7 questions in a session. Instagram, YouTube, Facebook. You can follow my personal page at @CattyCEO_Chris. Follow the channel. 7 questions in a session. Back to this interview.
Okay, looking okay?
You look great. You're doing fine.
Yo, man, we back at it, man. She had to take a quick break real fast. We had to get ourselves together.
She did change my voice.
And tell you, dope ass interview. This is probably going to be one of my highest viewed interviews, guaranteed. But I'm going to do it like this, man, since I do see y'all doing more than one thing, like, What's y'all most best thing to do, I say, promoting, dancing, or bartending?
What you mean by best?
Like, what do you prefer more?
I like bartending, but it come with the same smoke, like the same drama. But I like bartending. I fuck with bartending. It just come with the same shit.
It's emotion.
Yeah.
It's about boys.
Anything, man. Anytime it has something to do with money, It's gonna be ugly. First of all, you know, females already catty. Females already are jealous. Females already, like, always gossip. You know, females is different. I mean, you know they not, because the niggas starting to act like the females these days. Man. So, you know, when you dealing with females, you dealing with gossip, jealousy, catty bullshit. You know what I'm saying? So, and then it's money involved. So it's always gonna be there. when it comes to tips and fast money, it's always gonna be the same shit.
So I'm gonna get into the bullshit there, man. I'm gonna get into the bullshit. Do you like being the topic of these podcasts that's going around right now? Because lately you've been the topic. So how you feel about that, man? People having them conversations about you when you ain't around and shit.
It makes me feel like when I watch a TV show or something, like, I don't know, like with the celebrities and shit, you know? I mean, I ain't no small fry around this city. I'm Big Doe, Jane Doe, Jane Doe Get Doe. Like, I've really been doing my thing for a long time now. Everybody know who the fuck I am. So it's just like when motherfuckers bring me up on podcasts, it's just like, keep my name going. Keep me relevant. Keep talking about me. You know what I'm saying? Everybody know Jane Doe. Don't forget about me. Bring me up 10 more years from now.
Like, do it bother you when people still talk about old shit?
At first it did, but now it don't no more. Because like I said, keep me relevant. If you want to keep bringing my name up, bringing up old shit that happened like 20 years ago, then go ahead. Go keep bringing it up. I don't give a fuck. It just came up again on Big Money podcast. Shout out to Big Money. It just, somebody called in, said some shit about, oh, I uploaded Jane Doe getting pissed on, like, another motherfucker called and said, "Nah, Jane Doe to go." Like, now all you bitches want to get pissed on. So it's just like, now all you bitches want to be as freaky as me. So it's just now all you bitches, y'all, oh, why my nigga be dreaming about Jane Doe, wanting to fuck Jane Doe? Yeah, that's why.
Do it bother you, people talking about you on the net?
No, I expect them in the first of the year, but.
Somebody said, on me, everybody know Jane Doe.
No, we don't bother. Y'all be expecting that type of shit, though. That blunt really just changed my voice, but it worked.
Hey, you put it down.
What the fuck?
Oh, man.
I ain't gonna lie. With her being my friend, it's a lot more attention than I already was getting. I was already buzzing. But, you know, people, if they don't like her, they ain't gonna like me. If they don't like me, they not gonna like her because we spend so much time together. Them, so it be expected though.
Man, if y'all can look at the camera right now and tell y'all haters one thing, what would y'all tell them?
I don't know. Fuck y'all. If my haters watching right now, I just want to tell y'all,
I'm blessed and God bless you. Pray. Get your life right or something. Because it's just like.
And eat a bowl of dicks.
Eat a bowl of dicks. Like, oh, man. Eat a bowl of dicks. drink bleach.
Man, if it's 1 a.m, y'all by yourself, what gas station y'all not stopping at?
None. I'm not stopping at no gas station. I will drive all the way. I know how far I can get with my truck. My truck. Yep.
I can tell you. I know my house. This many miles away. I get there.
I know how far to go.
I'm not going to no gas station.
The gas station's by my house closed at 9 p.m. So I'm most definitely not going to the gas station on North Side.
Man, who y'all favorite Milwaukee artist right now?
Well, you can go first.
Mm-hmm. Let me wait.
Well, my favorite Milwaukee artist.
Wait. You got.
Oh, they had to ponder. They had to ponder.
I have a list.
Oh, go ahead.
I got a list of my favorite artists. So
yeah, we can say a list because I feel like that's.
First of all, we gonna start with my cousin Looney Baby, Guapo Chapo, the show. They're my little cousins. They've been rapping since they was like 8. I know.
Chop Man, come on the show.
Big Chicken.
Chicken, what it do?
SME Tax Free.
Tax, that's my dog.
Who else? Funny Money, Big Steph.
Both of them supposed to be coming out soon.
It's a bunch of them.
Will.
Up top, Will, K-Rex,
Big Tone.
It's a lot of favorites. I listen to Milwaukee.
We got a lot of favorites
all the time. And the Milwaukee, the Milwaukee rappers, artists, they come throw a bag. They show love. I have so much Milwaukee artists on my phone because they show me so much love. I be bumping they shit.
I feel like the city finally starting to take over a little bit. Like the industry don't want to accept it yet, but. Like TikTok and all these other platforms tell it the city is starting to take over little by little.
Milwaukee is that city. Like, everywhere I go, motherfuckers be like, "Oh, you from Milwaukee? I heard about Milwaukee."
Chicken.
them niggas get money in Milwaukee. Like, listen, I have a love-hate relationship with this place. Like, I hate all the bullshit, the drama, all the niggas killing each other. And that's one thing. I want to say, stop the violence.
For real.
All the killing and shit. Like, what you niggas mad about? It's a whole bunch of money out here.
Fucking up the money with this. They fucking up the money.
Listen, it's a whole bunch of money out here. It's a whole bunch of bitches. It's a whole bunch of hoes out here. What y'all beefing about?
That's exactly what they beefing about, the hoes.
Stop beefing about that.
I hope these niggas not beefing about the hoes. No. Not beefing about the hoes. But I get it, though. I get it. It's a shortage on the bad hoes. You know what I'm saying? So, it's a shortage on bad bitches. So, I get it. Same with the bitches. I see why the bitches be fighting, because it's a shortage on the niggas.
On the rich niggas.
Well, the niggas that's up here. It's a shortage on the rich niggas that's up here. But, you know, the ratio fucked up. Niggas is dying every day.
We just said, the rich niggas. Them different.
the different ones. Not the regular. Not the basic. Not the standard. Cream. Not the standard niggas. We talking about
the rich niggas.
The premium. The premium niggas.
I like that nigga with a check.
We talk about the premium niggas. You got the standard, basic, regular, then you got the premium. The premium niggas.
Talking about that, one of the questions I was going to ask y'all is, do y'all feel like dating is hard in Milwaukee?
Yes.
Absolutely.
Dating is so hard in Milwaukee. Super fucking hard. Super hard. You want to know why it's super hard? I'm going to break it down to y'all, but I'm going to get off live because y'all gotta log into the channel and see the rest of the interview. Yeah, we going to get off live now.
Hey, what's with that?
We got to get off live because they got to log in.
I think I'm high.
Yeah.
I don't smoke at all. I think that's a big one.
So, I'm done.
I just took in a big portion.
We smoked one weed.
Matter of fact, happy 420, man. 420, today is April 20th, 2023, man. 420, roll you a billionaire. They get high. Leave them tobacco products alone. Treat your lungs better.
Okay. I feel like dating is hard and fucked up in Milwaukee because the ratio is fucked up. Like we was just talking about. The premium niggas. The ratio is fucked up on the premium niggas. You got niggas dying every day, getting killed. You got niggas in jail, getting snitched on. And then you got niggas that's on the low, going both ways. So, the premium niggas is kind of like, would you say 5 or 10? Bitches to a nigga. 5 or 10.
After the one we know, I'm going to say 10. 10, I think.
Ooh, 10. After what I just had, I would say like 10. It's like 10 bitches to a nigga. It's like 10 bitches to a nigga. So, it's kind of like these days, you either gonna be sister soldier, you gonna love yourself and be by yourself and not put up for that bullshit, or you gonna be a team motherfucking player and shut the fuck up and get the bills and shit paid, okay? That's what the fuck you gonna do. You gotta be a silly ass bitch to catch your nigga cheating knowing you can't pay the bills, okay? And I ain't talking about the petty bills. I'm talking about the bad bitch, the grown up, the premium bitch bills. The premium bitch bills. The rent started at $2,000. Oh, you fucking with who, man? Mine. Go ahead.
Barbara, I am not Shirley.
Barbara, I am not Shirley.
Hey, y'all got me crying over here. Y'all
I am not sure. I fucked up my one nigga. I'm like, baby, I'm sorry. Come back.
Do y'all feel like y'all are trendsetters here?
Most definitely.
Feel like they be copying y'all. They be
all the time. They be stealing personalities,
dance moves, hairstyles, hair colors.
No. That shit. Everybody is influenced or like somebody got want to get it. But I'm talking about when bitches be trying to like steal your personality, do shit like you, and just, I like people that have like their own personality, own image. Like you see her, she today, she's sexy, got her boots and shit on. I got on some Yeezys, a t-shirt, like, you know, she feeling sexy. Her mood is,
ooh,
yeah. Shit, mine is, I want to be comfortable. It is what it is. I'm chilling. I'm cool.
Yeah, well, shit, I appreciate y'all for coming through. Man, this part, I was just saying, this part of the interview, the camera on y'all. Let everybody know, y'all social media, where to follow y'all, what y'all got coming next.
Follow me on Instagram at He Like Mulan.
Follow me on Instagram at Big Doe ENT. I might change in 2 weeks. I change my name like every other week. But for now, it's Big Doe ENT. It was just Crystal, but I had to go back to be a Big Doe ENT because I thought these bitches forgot who I was. So yeah, I had to go back to Big Doe ENT.
And shout outs.
Shout out to my hairstylist, Shari. Shari did it. Shout out to her. She keep me dead every week. She don't fuck around. She don't play about me. Shout out to everybody. Shout out to the East Side. I want the East. I don't know.
Shout out all family and friends. Nobody can be mad because that means
right.
I'm playing that shit.
Shit. And I am your little Caddy Chris, man. Thank you for watching 7 Questions in the Session. Again, shout out to our sponsors, Billionaire Hemp Wraps. Treat your lungs better. Stop smoking that tobacco. Spray 420, best cardioterizer out there. Follow them ASAP. It ate off the bone. Men's and female oils. Come get you some so you can get you some, man. Telling you, you mix that with your cologne, whatever cologne you decide to wear, I guarantee you. And she high, one hit, smoke a billionaire. We up out of here, man. 7 Questions in the Session. Subscribe to the channel. See y'all next interview, man. I'm high too. I ain't gonna be honest. Happy 420. Like 5 grams in one blood.
5 grams in one month.
And I still got my cross blunt. I ain't even rolled yet. I mean, I ain't even smoked yet. That's how high I am.
I'm so glad I only hit it once. Because I'm going to be so tired right now. What is going on?
First of all, this man said 5 grams in one blunt. Whoa. I don't even know what that is. I just call it.
I'm gonna have to block out the plates.
Yeah, if let me say, if you're tripping, if you ain't got a Benz, you're doing it wrong. You're doing it wrong.
Yeah.
Me and Sonny knocking hoes like Will Chamberlain. I ain't never shot a jump shot, but my wrist fame. My nigga was a hooper, now he dumping shit, I can't blame. I know some niggas always posting guns, but they can't aim.
Tryna make me switch up on the team, but you couldn't pay. Baby, you would never catch me on the scene, cause I'm high maintenance. Sick of pouring all this damn lean, got me feeling crazy. I just got a box of woods, finna roll a Tracy.
Just bought a blender, now